Hey, we are Oh Wonder.
And these are records in my life. Or our lives. Grammar.
Hi guys, thanks for checking out Records in My Life. We're here with Anthony and Josephine from Oh Wonder. Thanks guys.
Thanks for having us.
How you doing?
I appreciate you being on the show. I'm fine, thank you. Tell us what's new, what's exciting.
We are here at the Malkin Bowl in Vancouver, and it's the first date of our world tour, which is strange to say.
Yeah, we have another 4 months to go, so you've caught us at the right time when we're full of energy and not tired.
Yeah.
And, I mean, you guys just got off, but a whole whirlwind of summer shows as well, right? Like, tell me quickly about some of the highlights.
Yeah, so we did our first Asian tour, which was absolutely incredible. We visited, where did we go? Bangkok, Philippines, South Korea.
Tokyo. We did Australia. We did, can't miss them out, Hong Kong, Singapore, Kuala Lumpur, cross. You missed out a country. We did a great Asia tour for a month. It was wicked.
Yeah.
So were you loving your booking agent or hating your booking agent?
Yeah. It's love and hate on a daily basis.
Yeah. Totally.
Yeah. When you're doing that many flights every day, it's pretty fun.
Yeah.
So did you, out of all those travels, was there an album that you or an artist that you picked up on?
Yeah. There actually is a guy in Australia called DD Dumbo. He's from Melbourne. And he's just this kind of under-the-radar dude who we came onto from Luke, who does, mm-hmm. who's on tour with us. He makes playlists every month, and he was like right at the bottom of this playlist, and it was a song called Walrus, and we totally fell in love with it. And ever since then, we've been listening to his record, which is called Utopia Defeated.
It's beautiful instrumentation. There's like clarinets all the way through it. It's really magical.
Classical.
Yeah.
It's amazing.
Did he produce, like, was he able to self-produce the record?
Yeah, I think so.
Right?
Yeah, he's a feral genius.
It's kind of one of those Kevin Parker dudes where he just kind of creates the whole.
Yeah, just. Yeah, something from nothing kind of thing.
So let's, we're sitting in a living room and you guys are, you guys play great music, you make people dance and, people are really, how do we get it dancing? How do we get it moving?
Ooh, we put on Sylvan Esso, one of our favorite bands. They are another great duo. And another great duo, not that we're great, but we are a duo. They're another duo who are great. And they have just released their second record called What Now? And there's a tune in it called The Glow. And it literally makes me, it's one of those songs that you feel like you've known forever that's like soundtracked your life. It's so nostalgic and it's so dreamy.
Yeah, it's nostalgic straight away.
But we put it on before we go on stage every night and we're all just like dancing in the dressing room. We keep doing that, right?
Yeah, it's a great record and great for running.
Good running music.
Really good running music. There's also another band called Everything. Back from
I just did a run this morning
Manchester.
Around here to their album.
Yeah. Wow, it's perfect running music. It just gets you so hyped. They've just released an album
last week. Guys are the healthiest touring people. That's the first time I've ever heard. Is that the first time I've heard a reference to jogging?
Oh, really?
That's awesome, yeah.
Sounds better than, sitting in a bar late at night on the tour.
Sounds good.
It was a good run. It was refreshing.
Yeah.
How about a record with all the traveling? What's good traveling music to listen to? Spending so much time on an airplane, a bus.
I listen to like comforting things, like James Taylor records that I grew up listening to, and like Joni Mitchell records. They just make me feel like I'm at home again. Labby Ziffrey.
I listened to Carole King yesterday.
Did you?
On the flight.
Yeah, it's like kind of our parents' generation of music. We both grew up on that as kids. Like, on family holidays, you'd be in the back of the car driving around the UK and like James Taylor would be on, you'd all be singing and
pretending
you're
in California.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah. I listened to a lot of that on tour.
That's great. I always like to ask the question, like family drives and stuff, but sometimes a little leery about delving into someone's personal life.
Didn't have family drives.
Well, that's exactly it, right? There were no
deprived childhood.
Well, yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, that's it.
They're never as romantic as they sound, though. They're always pretty rubbish.
Right. Yeah, it's kind of nice music, then arguments.
Yeah, basically. I think I threw a packet of Starburst at my mum while she was driving once, and we had this whole big argument on the side of the road when I was about six. And I was like, I didn't
you
throw them, my brother
did. You were arguing
with
your parents at six?
Yeah.
Wow.
Contrary.
I didn't
nice
get the confidence
child.
To do that till I was like 24.
So let's do, you mentioned romance. Let's do a good first date record.
Ooh. seeing that we're in Canada, I guess Feist is a good one for us. She makes incredible records. The Reminder is probably our favourite still to this day.
Yeah, and there's a beautiful documentary she made called Look at What the Light Did Now, which is kind of the way she made it, basically. She hired this huge house in Paris and hired these people to kind of film it, film the process. And it's a beautiful record, and it's perfect if you're trying to, like, not be too obvious. Like, I really fancy you and I want to kind of, you know, move things along.
The album or the...
The album, yeah. If you put that on it, it's not like, oh, I really like you. Let's, you know, get it's down quite, to business. Do you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You said first date.
It's a first date thing.
Yeah, it's nice.
It's a nice record.
It's a safe, nice record.
Yeah, yeah.
It's lovely.
I mean, I wouldn't think you'd want to put on something.
No, it's not going to make any babies or anything. Yeah, that'd be so intense.
Which has been referenced, but anyway. let's do one final one. Let's do a... The humidity, my brain. Sometimes I forget.
It's this red sun.
It's like, what are you guys listening today? Give us a new artist which you can recommend.
Ooh, that's a good question. Who was the last person we found? There is a kid from, I think he's from London, called Jacob Collier, and we've only just come onto him. And have you heard of him?
I don't think I have. I might. You know, it sounds silly. I don't think I have.
He's basically like a genius, a musical genius. He won a Grammy, I think, for his record last year.
He's written his own scales. Like,
that's incredible.
He's like writing a new type of music. It's bizarre.
Yeah, it's like really modern jazz, but beautiful. And yeah, we've been listening to his records.
He's the most interesting follow on Instagram because he'll just like put his phone on during his sound check and he'll just sit at a piano.
For like an hour, just
playing.
And
just do improvised jazz. And he's just chatting to his crew, and he's just like,
he's like, I'll get a sandwich. It's like insane. He's amazing.
Yeah, his records are amazing.
Nice. Well, guys, thank you so much for taking the time to do this. I know you're busy.
Thanks for having us.
Good luck with everything.
And thank you.
Do you have any words of wisdom for the World Wide Webs of the world out there?
Just general words of wisdom.
Advice, a joke, usually, like any parting thoughts. Maybe that's the easiest thing to do.
I was going to give a riddle, but I shouldn't give a riddle.
Oh, that's a great one. Do that.
Okay, I've got a riddle. So, to end the show, here's a riddle. What has four letters, sometimes has nine letters, and never has five letters? She's bemused.
Oh, I don't know.
Tune in 36 hours to get the answer.
What's the
answer? No, because you can't do that to people. That's so mean.
I'm going to spell it out.
Oh.
So, what has four letters? Correct?
This isn't a riddle. You've just said a statement.
Sometimes has nine letters. Correct.
Oh, no.
And never has five letters.
That's
not a riddle. Torture your partners.
Riddled. She is riddled.
Oh, that's great.
Don't try to fight the riddle master.